Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for a Fishing Planet, and I'm going to show you guys the best money maker in the game at the moment. So somebody sent it to me and it's sturgeon fishing in California. So I searched for the YouTube and I thought there was already a very good guide or something around, but it seems there is not really a guide with all the info, with the time zones, with the spots. So I see a lot of videos that people are catching the sturgeon. But yeah, if you don't say how you need to get it, it's very hard. So this is the tutorial. If there is already another tutorial out that I missed, I'm very sorry for that. But yeah, then it's the second time that you can see it. So first of all, so we are going to fish for the sturgeon. I'm going to show you guys the bobber setup and I'm going to show you guys the feeder setup, because we got now feeders and the feeders, they work really well too. So we are going to do that. But first of all, I'm going to start with the weather. So we are going to fish at night. You don't need to fish that long because you can fill your net very fast. It's a shitload of money. Yeah, most of the time your net is going to be full and you can go to the next day. So we got three weather types here. So, and we got all the three here. So you guys can see it. You got the cloudy and then you got the cloudy. Then you got partly cloudy. Then you got a new moon, I think this is called. Then you got sunny and then you got the new moon. I don't think that you got the full moon here. No, I don't think so. So when do you need to fish? So in a cloudy day, you need to fish from 2 a.m. until 5 a.m. You guys can see it at 2 a.m. you guys see that you go to the best night time. Then on partly cloudy and a new moon, you need to fish from 11 to 1 p.m. so 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. it is. So you guys can see it here in this area. And then on a sunny and new moon, you need to fish from 9 p.m. until 11 p.m. Can you not get the sturgeon in the other time zone? No. I fished a little bit further too in the night, so you can still get the sturgeon, but it's a little bit harder because it's not the best time. So that's it. So for the setups, so I'm fishing with this one. So it's very strange, but you need to fish most of the time in the shallow. I don't understand it really well, because white sturgeon, they like to live in holes. So I saw that in Germany too, that not everything is okay with the new system. Because I see catfish not in holes. I don't understand that. I see some kind of species sitting on places that I don't like, the bream. The bream is unbelievable. I do all the holes in Germany and I don't got the bream, but here it's just the same. So they need to adjust that a little bit in the future. So this is 200 centimeters. That's only for one spot. I will show you guys what spot it is. But most of the time I'm going to fish here with 17 centimeters. So the green beer, that's the same like the Brutos. So it's just the same like Brutus 300. I'm now using this one. Thunderspin 5500, mono 0.5. Pear-shaped floater, hook 2.0, and spawn sack is very good. Then for the feeder setup, I'm using the Mega Tuber 400, Thunderspin 5500, Flora 0.55, Sinker 200, monoliter 0.4, hook 2.0, spawn sack. And I'm using this bell. It's sensitive very high, so it's a little bit harder to fish because you need to watch your tension on your tension bar. But that are the two setups. So yeah, let's get started, guys. So yeah, where do you need to go? That's very important too. So you need to go to the fishing, the beaver. That's the spot that you need to be. So let's go fishing. So you guys can already see I got one, I got two. I need to put it on Azerdi. 3, 4, 5, 6 spots. So 6 spots that you can get it. So for this spot, this one, I'm going to show you guys all the spots that you know what the distance is. So for this spot with the bobber, so we are going to the bobber, you need to go 200 centimeters. So that's 2 meters. So you just throw over here. So that's number one. And I'm not sure because it's cloudy. It's possible that I'm going to the next day because it's almost done with the best time of the night, I need to say. So it's already getting light. So that's spot number one. So that's 35 meters that you need to throw. And now we need to wait, and I hope that I'm going to get the fish. If I don't get the fish, I'm just going to show you guys all the other spots with the distance. Then we are going to the next fishing day, and I'm going to catch a couple of white sturgeons so that you guys got all the info, because normally it doesn't take this long. Normally you throw in and you get the fish, and I'm going to show you guys my net too, because I totally forgot. So yeah, I'm not going to get a bite because my last two sturgeon were on this position. So you guys can see it, this position. If you want to check it, just stop the video. Just check it, run a little bit around. If you go to those positions here, you just need to go to 70 centimeters. And here you need to throw around 30, 33 meters. That's the sweet spot. So you will see it here. So if I'm on the marker, 32 meters, that's perfect. Bobber is straight, so I'm not hitting the bottom. So this is shallow. So they are, the most spots are in the shallow area. So this is the second one. Then the next one, the third one, is just near it. You guys can see it. It's just the same. It's 33 too. So they are all the same. So 30 to 33, that's good. So that's all those three. Then you come here to this one. This one is around 10 meters. You can go 70 centimeters too. And then you just need to wait. Throw a little bit to the right, because you guys see that the current is going to the left. So this is 9 to 10 meters. And then we go to the last one. There are more, but for me that's more than enough. So you just come over here. You just throw on this marker. And that are the six markers, I think, that I showed you. Yeah, six markers. And that's where you can get the sturgeon. So, yeah, and here I got a bite. So, sometimes you need to just alternate a little bit. If you don't get a bite, just go to the next position. So, that's how you need to do it in this game. Because not every spot is always active. And this is a sturgeon. Sometimes you get a steelhead, you get the chinook. Here is the sturgeon. So, you guys can see it. Okay, so you guys can see it. It's a shitload of money that those fish are making. It's very easy fishing. So you guys can see it here. 70,000 currency I got. I fished, I think, 2 hours in game. That's 30 minutes in real life. You can get full net too. If you're very lucky, you can get full net too. This is with premium, I need to say. But there is no doubt about it. It's the best money maker in the game. And what I saw is very strange. So I'm not sure how long this is already in the game, but I didn't play the game for, I can say, at least 1 year. I started back playing on the test server, but there is no cooldown anymore. So if you forward the time to the next night. Ah, now I got the cooldown. Yeah, check. Here it stops. So it just resets at 9 to 5 a.m. I thought that you don't need to get a next forward cooldown if you... yeah, your time is between 9 and 5, but here it just stop check. Cooldown for the next fast forward is 0. So you can always just forward time. You never need to wait. If you fish 30 minutes or 50 minutes, you can just go to the next day. So I didn't know that. That was in the game. So it's very easy fishing that way, because you're never going to have a cooldown. Because the first time that you need to start is 9 p.m. So, and it's always going to be resetted. So let's have a look. So we are now here. The next day is this one. So I'm going to check my paper. It's 11 p.m. until 1 a.m. So we are going now to 11. So that's 23 hours. So forward the time. 2,000 to stay here. 17,000. And you guys can see it. Experience is 3,000. So it's a very good money maker. Experience is a little bit less. So if you do a partly cloudy the whole time in Alaska with Dolly Vardens and with the unique sockeye, so unique Dolly Vardens, unique sockeye, you can get easily 10. That's around 10,000 already experience and all the others. So you're going to make 15,000 on Alaska. But the main problem is it's only partly cloudy. Here you can fish every night. So this is a lot easier. You don't need to use bait coins either. So I tested Alaska, but this is better. I think even better for experience too. So for money, for sure, it's a lot easier to fish. So what we are going to do now is I'm going to switch to the feeder fishing. So let's have a look. It's 11 p.m. So now we are going to throw over here just the same. So you can go, let's have a look, 28 meters, that's on the edge. I hope that I'm going to get the bite. So here is, yeah, a little bit, yeah, how can I say it? It's not complicated, but you need to train a little bit this kind of fishing. Because you need to wait. Check, now I got a bite. Check my tension. I need to wait. Yeah, it's good. Did you guys see it? So you just need to reel a little bit. And if you see your tension popping up, you need to strike. So the key about feeder fishing is waiting. Of course, you can just put a rod pot out too. It's going to be a lot easier. But because you need to alternate the whole time with your positions here, it's not that good. You can, of course, if you got like two feeder setups, you can throw one at the left, one at the right. It's maybe a little bit faster too, but it's already so fast, this fishing, that yeah, I cannot get bothered, to be honest. So let's try this position now, and then I'm going to end the video. And I'm going to check for a brief moment that I still got no cooldown on the forward time. So this is a little bit too far. So let's put 33, let's zoom in. And let's have a look that we can get a second one. Yeah, check. There is the bite. Wait, yeah, that's, did you see it? You got like, chook, and your tension goes up, and then you need to strike. That's how easy you can do it, guys. That's already 4,000 currency that I just made. And what is it? 10 minutes in game. So, yeah, that's 1/4 of 50 minutes, so that's like 2-3 minutes in real life. So, yeah, there is no doubt about it. Just come here, start farming, get the money in, because you are going to need it for the higher level lakes. You can, yeah, level up here too, because, yeah. So, here is another sturgeon, and this is a very fat one. So, here is. So 2,400 currency. So I started, yeah, here when I was level 44. This is the third day, and you guys can see it. So yeah, that was the video, guys. Did I say everything to you guys? I think I said everything to you guys. So happy farming over here. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Maybe I'm going to make a video about what I think that they need to change at the moment, because I see some mechanics that in the future are going to break the game, I think. And it's about the new lakes. I see a lot of stuff that they need to tweak. Otherwise, it's going to be very hard. Because what I see is that they yeah, make the mechanic the same as the old lakes in the new lakes. But with the migration of fish, that's not possible anymore, I think. Because I tested Germany like for 10-20 hours. And yeah, there is a lot of stuff that they need to look at, because otherwise it's not going to work. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun. Bye-bye.